catchphrase. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, people of all ages. I'm Kirk Yeehee, and this is Sorority Rights. I know what you're thinking. I'm playing a game about sorority girls. Yeah, that's probably long and short of it. But we'll see. So this is from the same guy that created DearEvil.exe. As you guys know, I absolutely love that game. And I asked on the Steam forums if there's any others, blah, blah, blah. This is the first game we should have started with. It's all an interconnecting story. We know how it ends so far. Now, we're going back to see how it begins. So, I'll be playing through this, then I'll be playing through The Last Yandere after this, which both of these are visual novels. This only has 3 chapters, so I'm hoping it won't be too long. Probably not making it any shorter by sitting here talking. Let's get started, guys. Chapter 1. Okay, I thought I was moving that for a second. Jeez. Wait, what? Wah! This is... I was expecting a visual novel, not this. What's going on? It says press spacebar to jump. I'm not hitting spacebar. Okay. I was not expecting this at all. Guys! What? Throw me for a loop right off the bat. I was expecting what we're seeing right now. And as you can see, yeah, someone we recognize right off the bat. The animation's a little different in this, but that's to be expected. This was earlier work. Typically with stuff like, hey, you progress with time. Still, we know who this is. At least I think we do. This should be Yana. 17, not bad for my first time. I've been wanting to play this for a long time. I haven't felt this excited in a while. Oh my god, this is me! Like seriously, I've been just itching to play this. I just had to wait until I had an excuse to record again, or a chance to record again might be the better way to say it. And today is that day, because I have no material going out tomorrow. Yeah, some stuff got switched around. You'll see what all that's about here in the upcoming days. Has to do with Mega Man Maker. We'll just leave it at that for now. To be honest, I've always been a bit of an introvert. Speaking to the choir once again, it's probably the case for a lot of us, and if you don't know what an introvert is, sorry for interrupting the story so much already. We're 2 lines in. But an introvert is basically someone that doesn't like to socialize. If you want to give an extremely simple explanation of it. Someone who doesn't go out and socialize. Someone who keeps into themselves and would rather stay into themselves than go out into the real world. That's the simple explanation for it. The quick explanation. But yeah, if you want to know more, there's a lot more depth to it. Just Google it. It's the easiest way to say. I gave you the basic explanation. Didn't even know what introvert and extrovert and stuff like that was until about 2 years ago. Okay, let's continue on, guys. I was never excited going to school. I didn't have friends. What else should I look forward to? Schoolwork? Alright, developer, is this character me? Seriously. In school, I have 1 friend. Quite literally. Just the 1 friend in school. I didn't socialize with anyone else. Days that he'd be sick. He got extremely stressed during exams 1 year, and he missed like a week leading up to the exams. I was lost without him. I just wandered the halls. It was rough not having my friend around. My 1 and only friend. And to this day, I have like 3 friends. In any case, she's me to a nutshell so far. If only I could stay in all day and play games somehow. Huh. That would be cool. I just got this unreleased Apsir game from the internet. It looks old and strange. Probably why it wasn't released. I'm not late yet. I think I could play 1 round. Okay, Miles. Ultimate Gamer mode on. Oh, this is Miles! The purple hair and stuff made me think it was Yana. I should have known, though. Yana has longer hair and it doesn't poof out. Yeah, okay. So, we'll learn about Miles in this one. I'm guessing it'll be this game, something happens to her. And it'll probably have to do with the game she's playing right now. This will be the game that the developer shoved her soul in, or however it's going to work, I don't know. Kind of hate that we already know a part of how, like, the end game is. But it's really interesting to see the story that's going to lead up to it. I should probably continue on. We're like 8 minutes in. Of course, several of that was beforehand, but I keep... Okay, I guess we're playing again. space to jump. Okay, so, well, did horrible that time. Not for release. I like that. I am making the same mistakes. No, I want to beat my best. And that's probably going to be the mistake. Okay, no. Wait, what did I jump off of there? I have to go up to that every time. I might as well just use it. I didn't press anything. Okay. I'm going to have this poor girl so late for school. Oh, no! Ah! It's not a bug. It's a feature. Am I right, Dev? Am I right? No! How did I do 7, or how did I get to 17 the first time when I can't do anything this time? I think I worked better off the damn panic. Like, seriously, I can't do anything this time. Okay. No. Now, I thought, Dev Note, test subject number 9. Wait, what? So, it is showing how many times I died, I guess. Okay, nope, I made the same mistake again. I don't know why, the first time I did so well with this. Now I see the patterns, and I'm trying to land spots that I wasn't trying before. Before, I was just using double jump everywhere. I'm actually trying to focus on getting the gems more than anything that's costing me. Funny enough. That's like the objective. If I had a little better... Wait, I didn't touch down anywhere! If I had a little better pacing! Okay. No! Alright, I better stop playing. Her dad's gonna get mad at me. Young lady, need I remind you that you are late for school? Stop playing those games. Take these books and head on over. Be excited. You might meet some friends there. Dad, I'm not a kid anymore. I'm an adult now. I'm not the type to get excited at the thought of meeting new friends. I don't know what she thinks an adult is. Adults can get excited meeting new people. I get nervous as old heck, but... That's an introvert for ya. Well, not anymore. I've given up on that. What's the point? We're probably moving again soon anyway. Oh, so she's been a person that's had to move. That... I could see how that would turn you away from wanting to make friends. Because that's rough. Well, since it's just your second week of school, I figured you'd get more chances to meet friends. Stop it, Dad. This is all your fault. If you hadn't taken that stupid job with Dr. Rottenstein? We're going to call him Dr. Rott. I would have met people who would accept me for who I am if I had stayed in one place long enough. It doesn't matter. I don't think you care for me at all. All you think about is that stupid job. For 18 years, I was always known as the weird girl, the one with no friends, strict parents, and strange habits. I was an outcast in part because I love to smell every page of books I read. Weird, right? Just a bit, but you do you. You do you. Another was because I spent all day playing games. Turns out, people still discriminate gamers in 2014. Wow, this was made longer... quite a long while ago, a lot longer ago than I thought, you know, because DDLC was the first meta game I played, and yeah, apparently that's the genre, I don't know, but I assume this was just made in haste after that, but no, this may have been made long before that. I never really noticed the release date when I started the game up. I haven't had the chance to meet any local teens. I knew nobody, and was scared of having to make new friends. I haven't spoken to anyone down yet. I was too shy, you see. Until one day, I stepped on someone's foot, and they got pretty peeved at me. Oh, well, there you go. Ha, she did. Hey, watch it. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to stomp on your foot. I was just in a hurry. I was late for my next class. I've got to go. Not so fast, you clumsy wimpy. Clumsy wimpy? Really? I said I'm sorry. Venice? Now, get over it. We're both adults. We shouldn't make it a big deal. I hate when I stumble over my words. Put so many awkward jump cuts in there. I could leave all the little bit and all that in there, but no one wants to hear that, do ya? What did you just say to me? You already know me, huh? Or so you already know me, huh? Well, duh. Who would have not known the most famous girl on campus? Anyway, I really need to get going. I'm running late. Sorry about your shoes, though. She had such a sarcastic look on her face there. Oh no, dear. I'm not going to let you pass just like that. You see, these are new shoes, and you've ruined it. Excuse me? I'm pretty sure you're not deaf. You heard it right. You will pay for this. Can we talk about this later? I need to run. No running in the halls. Detention for you. Goddamn Baldy. Every time I see running or anything like that, that's what it associates with now. Just, I didn't play that game much. Run all you want, Wimpy. Meet me at the mansion, 5 p.m. sharp. Don't make me wait. Mansion? I'm sure she can... Entitled Prissy, son of a bee, is all she is right now. If you don't show up, there will be hell to pay. I don't know. Okay, I'll try. Nonsense, Wimpy. You don't have a choice. After class. I contemplated going in and paced back and forth at the idea. Do I really need to see Venice? Did I actually ruin her shoes? What did she mean by me paying for the ruined shoes? What does she want me to meet her at the mansion? Or why, rather, not what? Does she want me to literally pay for her shoes? I don't think I'll be able to afford it. Or worse, does she want me to fight her or something? I've never gotten into a fight before. Should I go home? Typical spoiled rich brat. Venice isn't really the type of person I should snub. She's the leader of a powerful sorority here. I may not have friends here, but I'm a good observer. A lot of students fear her because of her sorority's bullying. Oh, great. So, great. Bullying. Yeah, I know all about that, too. Seriously, really starting to feel a connection here with Miles. Like, just, she's a mirror of me so far, for the most part. I'm just waiting for the point that she'll snap, grab someone that's bullying her by the throat, and just start strangling them without even remembering it. Not gonna say I did that, but I definitely did that. Definitely did that. I just went blind with rage because just day in, day out, teasing constantly. He always sat behind me on the bus. He was assigned to that spot, and I got tired of it. I just turned around, grabbed him by the throat. He had both hands like this trying to move. He couldn't budge me. And then the bus driver, she just sat there and watched it. Because she saw what the bully kept doing to me time and time again. After about 30 seconds or so, she said, "All right, that's enough." And then it's like, I realized what I was doing, and I let go. He smartened up after that. I don't want to get bullied again. I've been through many schools, and it's time for this to stop. I'm going. Wait, is she part of a freaking cult? Girls, in an hour, we'll have someone new. A girl I met. I think she's the one.
Ooh, where's this going?
God, I shouldn't even have went there. She'll be entering the mansion soon. And yes, I had it set up. She won't be leaving. Don't worry. Sisters, our sorority has endured for 100 years. Our generation will usher in a new era. Soon, what is written in the guide stones will be a reality. Everything we've been planning for will happen. I basically peer pressured myself into meeting up with Venice. You're late. I'm here now. What are we doing here? Are you scared? Why? Is there anything to be scared of? Aw, such a cute, brave little wimpy girl we got here. Enough. I don't have much time for this. My dad is waiting for me at home. Duh. Why are you always in such a hurry? I got more important things to do, you know? Is that so? Just so you know, this awesome shoe is limited edition. And you bet I got no money to pay for it. Yeah, she's just snooty rich girl. I'm sure she has no money to pay for it. Oh, wait. Never mind. That was Miles saying that. My mistake. That was my mistake. I never noticed the name change. If I could rewind, I would. But I can't. And for that, you'll need to do something for me. I'm not surprised. I've heard so much about you. The gossips are true after all. You've heard it all right. You know what? I don't care. Oh, well, it's getting late and I still need to get my hair done for the party.
Will you cut it out? Just tell me what to do now.
Take a chill pill, Wimpy. Here's what you're gonna do. Spend the night in the infamous mansion. Just stay here for a night and we're even.
Are you out of your mind? Why would I do such craziness?
No way! Not only that, I have a deal for you.
A deal? What's in it for me?
I know you've been invisible to everyone at school and you don't have any friends. Rub it in, why don't you?
Not really an issue for me. I'm better off alone. I like it that way.
whatever, whatever it is, no thanks. I guess you believe in fairness and equality, right? Don't you want people to start treating you better?
I believe in that, yes. And it means people like you shouldn't force people to do what you want.
I see that you have a big mouth, too.
That's it. I'm leaving.
Your father wouldn't like that. What Venice wants, Venice gets. I don't know why I said that so sinisterly.
What?
Your father works at Rot Institute. I'm not even going to try that Rothenstein or however it is. Rot Institute.
How did you know?
Have my people look into you. If you don't do this, I'll have my aunt Lilith fire your father.
Oh, wow. What a...
It's a shame, too, since losing his wife, you and that job are all he has left.
Don't you dare talk about my parents, but... Okay, you have my attention, Venice.
You got it right, Wimpy. Don't worry, this is tradition. If you pass the test, you'll be a part of our sorority.
What?
You'll be respected and honored like every other member. You'll be popular among students and teachers alike. Your father will surely appreciate what you what you're about to do.
Appreciate what? Living by your rules?
I can trace back a curious and probably determinable aspect of my personality at that time. Truth is, I didn't mind staying at the mansion. I've read about it and its paranormal phenomena. I guess I just wanted to see it for myself. Aside from that, I may have hated my father's job, but I didn't want him to lose it. I didn't want him to lose anything again.
But why me?
You are a boring person. You have ruined my shoes.
Such a horrible excuse. It makes no sense.
Listen, I don't really care about joining your little group. Just promise not to bother me after tonight. Take a chill pill, clumsy. It's a deal. You have my word. There's a hair on my eyelash. There we go. Got that. Let's continue on.
Good.
If you accomplish this task, we'll teach you a whole... Or we'll tell the whole campus not to bother you. We will protect you. That includes us, too. We won't make your life miserable. Your father gets to keep his job. The opposite happens if you fail. The entire campus will be your enemies. You will not graduate. Everything you worked hard for, out the window.
Wow.
I know I've said this twice, but what a...
Why do you want me to go through this so bad? Honestly.
If you must know... I've been low on recruits this year, and I was hoping that, after this, you may consider joining. Sorority life isn't so bad. You'll get new friends, know a lot about the campus life, too. You'll have sisters who support you in your endeavors.
Endeavors?
You'll get a chance to engage philosophic activities, and we can make a difference in our community together. She almost sounds sincere here, but I don't buy it, not for a second. Not knowing, like, if this is anything like dareevil.exe. There's going to be some big twist in this, something that we don't expect. And I'm really curious and can't wait to see what that is. I may be a mean big sister to you, but I hope you consider joining us after tonight.
I'll think about it.
Why didn't I see it coming? Why did I have to be so stupid? What am I doing here? The mansion. It was an old Victorian-era mansion that was said to be haunted by the spirits. It is just a few blocks away from the campus. TV shows devoted entire episodes about this place. They said no one should enter this mansion, for it could kill you and take your soul. She's gonna die in here. She's gonna die in here. Oh no. I know it's been like hinting toward that all this time, but... And I sort of realized that, but it's just sunk in all of a sudden. She's gonna die here. She's gonna die in this. Damn, I really regret playing dareevil.exe first. Clickbait and fake news. When I was 12, I stopped believing in ghosts and spirits. So I always thought any story involving this house was nonsense, a hoax. All made up for ratings. Why here? We've always had our sorority rites here. The location for the initiation needed to be a place where great fear is felt. It allows us to stop wimps from you like joining the club. The place is perfect for that. And at night with no lights. The rules are simple. Spend the night in the mansion. You get to leave at 6 a.m. You are allowed to sleep. We'll know if you try to leave the mansion. Trust me, don't even try it. Also, no phones allowed. So she won't even be able to play her games, unless she sneaks it in somehow. I like the sarcasm here. What a great way to get people into a sorority. You give members heart attacks and mental issues. Hey, I don't tell you how to run your sorority, don't I? Oh, wait, that's right. You don't have one. Now, get your butt in there before I kick it. Ugh.
She's really hard to like.
Okay, so since we're at the end of chapter one, I'm thinking one chapter per video is probably the best way to do this. And one chapter is going to be about 20 to 23 minutes, I'll say. By the time I get little things cut out, like my... just tripping over my words. So we're going to hope that it's saved. We're going to hope that it's saved. If there was a way to check, that would be great, because I don't want to really sit here and do all this at once. Well, in any case, we're going to end things here officially. If it didn't save, I'll just skip through that stuff fast and start on chapter 2 when we next meet. So, if you haven't enjoyed this video, as always, leave it a big old thumbs up. I really appreciate that. If you want to, you can follow me on Twitter at KirkGeehee. Subscribe here on YouTube. Hit that little notification bell to be part of the notification squad. And make sure to select always be notified to be notified of my daily upcoming content. Other than that, I don't have too much to say. There's Top Buzz, Instagram, links down below. If you want to support me, watch a video or two over on Top Buzz. I'm starting to put little, like, 10 to 15 second clips over there. They actually do really well, and I'm actually getting paid a little bit because people are watching them. So if you don't have a ton of time to waste, and you have the Top Buzz app on your phone, feel free to search KirkGeehee and go to town. I really appreciate it. With that being said, guys, I think, yeah, I officially don't have anything else to say. I've shilled all I can shill. Looking forward to part two. I don't think I'm going to record it quite yet, because I've got other things I need to get out of the way too. So we'll get back to this one pretty soon. We'll get back to this one really soon, actually. For you guys, you might see it like just one day split in between, or they might all go up at once. I don't know. Time will tell, guys. Time will tell. With that being said, I'm officially done now. So see you later, guys, gals, my new YouTube pals. I'm KirkGeehee. But of course, I'm always KirkGeehee. Ha ha! See you guys in the next video.